Hey, Jay Shrek, Myths, Legend, and Lies. I'm in the most legendary town, ghost town, in the state of Arizona.
Jay Shrek, Myths, Legends, and Lies. Today we're going to talk about a ghost town. And that ghost town would be called Ruby. Now, in the town of Ruby, before it was the town of Ruby, the Spaniards in the 1700s found gold in that area. But they didn't believe that it was enough to be able to actually spend a lot of time there. And they had one thing that was intriguing to me, but not to them, was their safety. Because at that time, in the 1700s to the 1850s, the Apache were absolutely devastating in that area. And it was very difficult at that time to even worry about having enough time to be able to find gold, let alone staying alive. So their main key was, you know, let's stay alive. So until 1850, and then in 1870, they really kind of got going after that, 1870 to 1880. And that's when they started to really try to figure out exactly what Ruby had in store. And then the reality of Ruby was it wasn't Ruby then. You know, it didn't become the town of Ruby. In 1880, the Ruby Mercantile, which is world famous for a lot of different reasons, and some of them not extremely good, they sold the Ruby Mercantile in 1897. That was bought by Julius Andrews. Now, Julius Andrews had a wife, and guess what her name was? You guessed it, Ruby. So therefore, in 1897, the dusty dot on the map got a name, and it was called Ruby, Arizona. When that mercantile was sold to a John and Alexander Frazier, two brothers, they bought that mercantile. And then a very tragic thing happened. In the early 20s, seven desperados, villainistas they called them because they were part of Pancho Villa's crew, right? And they were Mexicans, and they came into town. You know, and the first thing in that mercantile, when they walked through those doors that are still standing today, they asked for tobacco. And you know, the only thing that makes that interesting is that there's been other massacres that have occurred, and the first thing that they asked for was tobacco. So tobacco was a deadly killer way before they even smoked it. So as Alexander turned around, they shot him in the back and the back of the head. And so his brother John then got shot in the face, right through the eye. How gruesome is that? And the unbelievable thing about that was he didn't die till 5 hours later. Well, they had a massive manhunt and they chased those desperados all over, but to no avail. And so therefore, 14 months later, a family came into town. And you know, they had their eye on that mercantile. And they thought, you know what? I think we'll buy it. Because they didn't believe at that point that 14 months later, the same thing could happen to them as happened to the Frazier brothers. They didn't find it would even be possible, right? But Frank and Myrtle Pearson purchased that mercantile. Now, they'd been told, do not purchase this mercantile. Because one of the mysteries about that was that when they built that mercantile in 1880, that was built on a Padre's grave. And they stated that anything that was built on that Padre's grave would be cursed. But the Pearsons didn't believe that that was even possible, right? Because what could happen like happened before? Could that happen again? What are the odds, right? Very minimal, right? You would think the odds of the same situation happening twice could happen again. But it did. And there was another desperados that came through those same doors as the seven came through before. Martinez and Silva, those two Mexican gentlemen, well, they shot the husband and they went after Margaret, the small girl. But as the mother was screaming, Silva noticed that she had gold teeth, right? So he let the girl go, basically, and went after the mother. And what he did is truly bloody and gory. He knocked her teeth out with the butt of his gun and then killed her. What happened after that was the largest manhunt in the state of Arizona ever. 700 men chased those two outlaws. They even brought a biplane in from Nogales, right? Wow. And they chased those outlaws night and day, and for 7 days, and they finally caught those two outlaws, and they took them to justice. And those two outlaws were supposed to hang, and one of the most incredible things happened, right? On the way to Florence, taking the prisoners up there, there was a mighty crash, right? And that cop car rolled over, and those two deputies ended up dead. Now, they're said that they jumped out of the car and somehow that caused that car to roll over, but they were also bludgeoned with a tool. And so another two men lost their lives hunting down the Martinez and Silvas gang. Another massive manhunt, right? And so they collect these two. They finally find them again, right? And they take them to prison. Now, Martinez, his fate and justice was served at the end of a rope. But Silva escaped again. And was never seen again. Now, so whether that is the legend of Ruby and that mercantile being built on that haunted ground, I don't know. But it makes for an interesting story. Now, if you get a chance to go to Ruby, one of the things you're going to find out is it is the most complete town in Arizona, ghost town that is. And it's a wonderful place to wander around.